Yes, so good evening, everyone. Thanks for joining us in our today's presentation. My name is Job Sikini, Chief Technical Analyst, Trade for FX. And first of all, let me thank you for all coming today. Thank you for making your time to be with us. My talk today is particularly relevant to many questions you've been asking in our various communities, and also to lay a strong foundation and a solid background on this game, as we've been finding many educators keeping the roots and history of all these exchanges and how they started. And that's something very important to you guys as you look forward to starting this game together. So without much ado, I'm going to share my screen to you guys so that you could get to see my presentation today. And also the subject today can be looked under the following headings. History of foreign exchange, introduction to gold standard, and also we can highlight some of the things we are going to talk about, like a few questions that cross your mind when you hear the term foreign exchange. So what is Forex trading? Why does Forex exist? Is Forex trading a sin? Is Forex trading important to the economy? Why is it important to study foreign exchange? Why was Forex created? Why is foreign exchange so unique in today's world? How much do Forex traders actually make a day? And who are the major participants in this market, including how can you become a successful trader? So don't worry about taking notes if you are not in a position to do so, because this will be recorded and posted in our YouTube channel for those ones also likely to miss out this one, so that they can have a chance to watch also. If you have any questions all through our class, we would like you to type them in our comment section below. And also you can write an official email to tradifyfx@gmail.com. Your questions will be answered. So without much ado, I'm just going to jump into the class so that you can start on what you are going to look at today. So I'm going to start by having a look at what is a professional Forex trader. Because you know, Forex trading can be divided into two subsections. We can have a retail Forex trading and professional Forex trading. So the definition of the definitions of these two terminologies can slightly differ, because how individually each of them conduct their issues. So professional trading is simply making the market and making money. So a professional Forex trader is someone who uses price movements in the foreign exchange currency to make profits. So by trading with an edge in the market, they can put odds in their favor to successfully trade price movement from point A to point B. Professional status as a Forex trader takes years of commitment and is backed up by clearly defined strategies that show consistent profitability, but also the rewards are worth the considerable effort. They can earn a high income and lifestyle that most folks can't dream about, only to blow their accounts in less than 90 days of their trading career. Now the retail traders. So professional trading is simply a very different kind of trading. You have to emulate different kind of tactics and different kind of strategies for you to consistently make money in this market, professional trading. Because as you know, many of us guys, we are retail traders. We trade from our phones, and all of what we do as individuals is mostly the small retail trading. So that's a simple definition of professional Forex trading, because professional Forex trading is simply making the market and making money. Professional traders are the ones who work in the banks, for example, investment banks, banks like Citibank, banks like Standard, and all those kind of investment banks, you know, all the banks, you know, actually they work in hedge funds and so many other kind of institutions in this field of Forex trading. And also we can look at what is retail Forex trading. So retail Forex trading has this different kind of definition, because it's just a small segment of the larger Forex exchange market where individuals just speculate on the exchange rate of the different currencies or the different trading currencies overnight. And you can just gain something on top of that in a night, being a day trader, or these kind of things. So this means since the introduction of online trading, anyone can enter the global marketplace through an online broker and access the same trades as banks do and financial institutions do. As retail traders, we have a chance now to join the market and also get to trade with the institutional traders, the bank traders and hedge fund traders, and also all those kinds of traders. But there's a difference. There's a very, very large a gap also, all a very, very large difference between retail Forex trading and professional Forex trading. So this, in terms of definitions and in terms of these, what these people do individually in their workplaces, because retail trading, you can do it from your bed. Maybe a professional trader might wake up in the morning, go to the office, try to make a schedule, try to prepare himself for what he's going to face through the day. So he's a trader that trades capital, bank capital, all sponsored capital, all provided capital, and is put there to safeguard the capital, not only to trade and make money, but also to risk manage and safeguard the capital for the institution itself. So for a retail trader, you trade your own capital with hopes of making pretty good money, I can say, or ridiculous returns for some of the guys who are starting the game thinking that you are going to get rich overnight. This also means that you have the retail mentality. So there's no much of information disadvantage for the retail traders, because there's actually a lot of internet. These days, there's a lot of evolution happening. There's a lot of technology. People can access internet from the comfort of their bed, from the comfort of their home. You don't have to go to an official place for you to trade this game. So there's much of information advantage for us, but also the bigger problem for retail traders is where there's too much information, it's very hard for you trying to filter and trying to process all the information that's out there to see what is important for you and what adds up for you as you start this game. Because not everything that is going to be provided out here that is going to show success when you try to bring these strategies into the market. So many people, thousands and thousands of strategies have been laid out outside here. So it's about you to choose which one to stand for. And you start by understanding the retail, first the retail market infrastructure itself. How is the retail industry made? How does it work? Who are the players? How can you get yourself to be a successful trader in the retail world? So proper research is mandatory for this one. For retail traders, proper research is mandatory, because you are always in a constant search for accredited data that may be very, very professional, or someone who knows at least what he's doing. Because a good mentor is what you must find for you to at least be consistent and profitable as a retail trader. So also, why does Forex exist is something that we are going to look into depth, because some of you guys have been asking, why does this game exist? Why was foreign exchange created? Why was this and this and that laid into purpose? So the whole purpose of trading Forex online for most people is to make money. Either you, either me, either your dad, either your sister, everyone who you heard of Forex trading. Also, you, the first time you heard of Forex trading, the idea that clicked into your mind is, how can you make money out of this large financial exchange that is laid down before your hands or before the world? So for corporations, sometimes they use it to offset a contract or future purchase that they plan to make. For corporations, I can give an example of KQ. I can give an example of which other company, maybe. Okay, let's go with the example of KQ. They want to buy oil from Canada. So what they do, they go to a bank and secure this transaction, this future transaction, because maybe they want to buy oil in 2 months, and they most likely there'll be currency fluctuations according to what is economically happening in our country. All the other country, the country from the other side, that means Canada. So they just go to the bank and try to secure this contract, the future contract, to secure price. Because if we have maybe a fluctuation of price and currently Kenyan shilling, one Kenyan shillings to US, to CAD, CAD is a Canadian dollar, might be 1 point something. So in case this increases to maybe from 1.2000 to 1.5000 in 2 months, as the KQ could have already done the finish the business with the bank, because for them, they into their books of records, they know they have already purchased oil from Canada at 1.2000. So in case anything happens, price fluctuates from 1.2000 to 1.5000. That's some points. It's upon the bank to know how they are going to protect these kind of fluctuations and still make the deal for the KQ to make the future purchase for the oil they are planning to do. So retail traders get involved into ANA dollar on the changes in values of currencies they are trading over time. This can be intraday, can be swing trading, can be all these kinds of things. So, but understanding history without skipping how the journey actually started is what we are interested about. The history dates back to July 1st, 1944, as many of you actually guys are not exposed to, in Bretton Woods, New Hampshire. So this is a meeting that happened. 44 countries sent their members to New Hampshire to look for policies and implementations and that were going to help the countries economically, most especially after these world wars happened in the individual countries. So that's where everything was born. It was just an agreement aimed to create a stable international financial system anchored by gold. So when the dollar became under speculative pressure later on, you can find that the central banks now had to intervene in the game, the gold market, to maintain the value of gold, and also to try to avoid inflation, especially after the world war had already happened and destroyed so much of the world's economy. So this will be talked in depth, into depth much later in the chapter by our own Kennedy Arogo. So in short, Forex is the backbone of international trades and global investing. So for those ones of you who've been saying Forex is a scam, Forex does not exist, this is just a short thing. So Forex has been there from times, from the 90s, from 1800s, when people used to conduct business through bartering system. So it's the backbone of international trades and global investing. And the Forex markets do not have any physical existence. You cannot say, hakuna mtu atakwambia these markets are there in Europe, they exist in a physical place in New York. There's no single place in the world where Forex dealers are located and have a designated place to be the Forex market. It's an online market, is where people come and engage, is where it's made up of money changers all over the world, and the market is interconnected via means of information, which was transmitted manually back then before the computers and the electronic means of communication came. And nowadays it's very, very easy to access the market. It's very efficient, it's very flexible. You can access it from your car, from your home, anywhere you can access the Forex market as long as you have a phone, you have internet connection and access to the MetaTrader 4, 5, platform, you can trade the Forex market together with what others are doing. So therefore, currency dealers or brokers in our neighborhood here as well as dealers in New York together all constitute an interconnected network of buyers and sellers. So this makes the largest world and largest market in the world, averaging to 6 trillion today, because there's so much liquidity in this market. This means there's so much willing buyers and so much willing sellers in the market, averaging to a sum of about $6 trillion a day being traded. So if you consider the total volume of imports and exports of even the individual countries trading Forex with their free floating currencies, or what we call fiat currencies, money does not change hands, because if Kenya does business with the United States, there's no money that's changing hands between the Kenyan banks and the United States banks. They don't send Kenyan money in physical to the United States for the purpose of making that purchase. So money does not change hands, but you know, transactions occur. As much as money does not change, transactions occur. So we are more interested in knowing how the transactions occur and where do they occur. Who are the major participants of making these transactions occur? And this is where we find the banks are the major participants, and also the retail Forex community, or the retail trading community, we also get engaged in these markets. So this is the host of the market, or simply the old financial marketplace in the world, because this dates back to when we used to do business, the old times when business was conducted through bartering system also. So some of you also have been asking yourself, is Forex trading a scene? I don't know where this comes off from, but yes, some people tend to relate Forex trading as scene when they find themselves getting married to their own self. Have you ever heard of someone saying, someone ever sleeping, the last thing that you look before you look into before you get to your bed is your charts, is Forex, and the first thing that you look in the morning when you wake up is the charts. That's just a simple way of getting married to your kids and getting too much attachment to your account till you forget your own way of thinking, your own way of spirituality, your own way of making things work for you. So that's completely an analogy that you couldn't encourage because you don't drag the ideology to people who want to change their lives, people who have dreams about their families, you don't want to change the perceptions about the game. That's how deep things are, and that's how it has been laid out. Trading Forex is a business like any other business. You don't have to bring sinning into this. But when you foolishly do it, when you act like a mad person trading Forex instead of wisely, even when 80% of retailers trade and lose their money, trading is still not as in, still like a business like any other. You need to treat this business like any other for you to realize success. You don't have to blame anybody for your own mistakes in this game. So though we have a few trading scenes, for us traders, we call them trading scenes because these are what makes us fall into the same traps and pits each and every day. So repeating the same mistakes over and over again, which leads to horrible losses, is a list that can be classified as trading scenes to Forex traders that has been in the game for quite a while. But no biblical confirmation that actually trading Forex itself is a scene. Jumping to the next topic, is Forex trading important to the economy? Yes, because also we can find some economists in our class today trying to ask themselves, how is trading important to the economy? Or how does trading contribute to the economy of the individual countries involved in this business? So a country's economy relies on the demand for its currency. A country's economy relies on the demand for its currency. This, in other terms, means who wants to do business with you, who's exchanging money with you, because this makes the demand for your currency to the other people, or the desire to have your currency or to do business with you to other people boost your economy, because they are going to do business with you, they are going to import your goods, they are going to at least make something out of the economy. So the better a country's currency is doing, for example, the currencies from the strong regions like USA, Canada, Euro region. So these strong currencies you find mostly, the economies are also better because the better the economy will be both in short term and long term, because economic activity actually is what determines the demand for a particular currency. And also the economic data that is being released in that particular country, which in turn can affect the value of a certain currency. So the math is very simple. Powerful countries have strong economies and in turn currencies, which allows them to be more influential in the daily trades. You can take an example of the USD or the United States dollar, which has much or the highest volumes during the New York session. And this just shows you how powerful the economy is. So macroeconomic statistics such as inflation have greatest impact on the Forex market. Therefore, they are the main drivers of the Forex market. So this kind of macroeconomic statistics, for those guys of you who have done economics in as a course, things like inflation, we have things like CPI, we have things like unemployment data. So these are macroeconomic statistics that come out from a certain economy. They study what has been happening in the individual economy in terms of employment, in terms of how much have been they able to produce in terms of exports, imports, and such a kind of things. So why is it important to study foreign exchange as an individual? So, or as an individual or as an institution. So Forex trading gives a trader vast knowledge to navigate the platform easily. I can say that's the first advantage or the first thing that you should learn that Forex trading really helps us. It equips us with the proper training or the knowledge that we need to navigate the platform easily. Because when you open an MT4, there are so many. It's very, very complicated for a beginner. But with time, you get that you get to learn how to navigate, how to draw trend lines, how to do such and such things on the platform. So by training and by proper learning, you get to know how to navigate it. Also, information about the software used, the trading terminologies, the software used is MT4 on the phone, MT5 also, we have Seed Seda and all those kind of other platforms. Trading terminologies that can be used, trading terminologies, we have things like which terminology can we talk about? You can talk about stop loss, you can talk about profit, you can talk about order block, you can talk about labels, MACD, trend, all those kind of things. So who wants and controls the markets, you can be able to learn about these kind of things, because these are actually the basics that you need to know in any kind of market before you make any investment. So the including learning the market operations themselves are necessary for success. Which time are these market operated? Which sessions do we have? And how does price move from one point to another? Which makes price move from one point to another? You must first understand the basics from the grassroots to have confidence and autonomy to make trading decisions on your own. You could not depend people and your mentors for a very long time because people die. Things happen in people's lives. And if you depend on people each and every day, this means you are not ready and you don't have the confidence and the autonomy to decide or to make trading decisions on your own. And this market is purely about making independent decisions, because what you see is what you see as a sell, someone else in the same market might be seeing it as a buy. People trade what they see rather than what they perceive or what they told. So that makes you just a reliable trader, because also zero awareness or ignorance, as you know, the saying says, often leads to 100% collapse of the account or destruction of the account, because you just go there, you just bump into price, you want to buy, you want to sell at the worst wrong place you could have ever clicked the bottom. And this often leads to you destroying your own account. So I want just to take you through 1-2 trading tips I've gotten through the past few minutes I've been with you. So every day new traders enter the market in the quest for what they may consider a quick and easy profit. Every day we get new traders, every day novice traders trying to create accounts with their IBs. IBs is what you call introducing brokers. You're trying to create an account, you want to get rich, you want to build a house, you want to take your baby to somewhere good, all these kind of things you want to do from the market. So we may consider this as a quick and get rich quick scheme, but it always doesn't work that way. For you guys or for us guys who've been a bit long in the game, it doesn't always work like that. Always remember, before trading even begins, it is essential for traders to adapt how the market operates, along with all conditions correlated with Forex trading. It's always and always essential for you to adapt how the market operates. You must be able to see certain price actions and certain patterns developing each and every day before your computers, and be able to familiarize yourself with them, because when this happens each and every day, you get the confidence even to trade these kind of patterns before they even appear on your screen. So it's still important for you to get the best Forex education possible, even if you think you already have an idea of this, how this game works. There's no such a thing as you know how this thing works, because the Forex trading is very dynamic. We have, it is continually evolving, and trading abilities can always improve each and every day. So you cannot say you are there yet, but you are still to learn more, because each day you are trying to comfort yourself and trying to lazy out, saying that you already know everything that happens in the Forex market. It won't happen like that, because you are going to lose. The market is always the best teacher. And if you get to learn the market and what it does, you are going, I can promise you 100%, you are going to see success in this game. So gathering also the right sources of information is very important for optimization to trade effectively in the foreign market. You have to gather the right sources of information to you. As I said in the beginning, you have to filter what you take serious and what you don't have to take serious, because some mentors, some educators are here just for money. They don't want you to know the right things that work out for the market. So find out your right source of information. Who's teaching you on how to see certain kind of price action? Is everything that these guys are telling you working in the market? Is it workable? Can you chase that strategy or that implementation they are trying to put into your mind? So the right source of information is very, very important. For us, we can recommend ICT and also other 1-2 strategies that we are going to talk about in our future classes. So since there are no proper degrees for Forex trading, traders must be understanding and smart about where to develop a strong Forex education or Forex foundation. And this is where now the smart money comes in. How you willing to see the market from the retail side or from the institutional side. There are no degrees. You can't go to Harvard, you can't go to Howard, you can't go to Nairobi University and ask for Forex trading course. You cannot find a degree anywhere. Though we have trading educators who are profitable in the market, we have professional traders who've been in the game for quite a while. So you must have an understanding on who to approach and how do these people approach the market. Are they profitable? What are they doing each and every day? Try to emulate what they are doing if you want to see success on your own. And smart money concept, always try to emulate smart money concept. Always try to outsmart the normal guys, the normal retail traders who are trying to chase this quick money each and every day. And also we are going to look at now why was Forex created is a very, very important also reason. The purpose of Forex, why is Forex there each and every day? So the first Forex market, as you can see, was established in Amsterdam. That's roughly 500 years ago, but before that, about 2,500 to 3,000 years ago, we had the Greeks and the Egyptians trading goods and their currencies with molten and silver and gold coins. They were exchanging these molten silver and gold coins, all what we can call as electrum, and their value being determined by actual weight and their size, the size of what you are carrying, the size of the coins, the size of the gold were determined by their weight and actually their size. Much of this will be discussed on later in the chapter by our own Ken. So the main purpose of this system, as you can see, was for the currencies exchange and also to foster international trade and investments by enabling currency conversions. As an example that I gave you before, KQ doing business with one of the companies selling oil in Canada. So that those two companies, because now because of the existence of the Forex market, they can do currency conversions because these individual currencies are accepted internationally to do business. But with the Forex market, it can foster that international trade to happen because it can enable currency conversions between these individual banks from the individual countries. And hence the business can be done completely. So the market is unique as you may find it yourself or as normal. The market is very, very unique. It's not a normal market like any other market because actually even the kind of money that is traded here has never been traded in any other kind of market before. So it's a highly liquid market. And because of its sheer size and huge daily turnover volume, foreign exchange offers unmatched liquidity. And by unmatched liquidity, we can say so many willing buyers and so many willing sellers in the game. And what this means, there will always be a buyer for every seller and a seller for every buyer. That's what we call simultaneous. Yani for every buyer, lazima kukuwe na every seller. So Forex is also a high leverage market. You are not allowed to trade. You are allowed to trade on margins or leverage. And that's technically borrowed capital with Forex. You get more value for your money as the returns or the pipage value that your trades bring back to you. And this can be magnified 100-fold, 200-fold, 300-fold, 1,000-fold, like for XNets, 1,000 times leverage. However, you must always remember that there's always two sides of the coin. When the deal is too good, you must be always careful. Must be always cautious. So when it comes to leverage, also this applies the same way because it can mean the same way that the same way your money can be leveraged into profit, it can also be leveraged into losses. So there's also no deadlines or extensions to contend with in terms of trading. So because you can actually hold your trades up to a year, 2 years, 2 weeks, 1 day, as long as you feel like you've entered the position in the best place for you, or the position has been filled in the best position, the best price for you, you can hold that position as long as you want. So we have benefits of trading Forex. You have some 1-2 benefits of trading Forex. And these also might be used by the brokers to kill us, but we really, really, sorry guys, we really enjoy the ease and access of advantage of this thing, because you can do it anywhere from the world. You can do it traveling in your car, in an aeroplane, anywhere in the world. You can access the foreign exchange market and your account from anywhere in the world. Also, traders get a 24-hour trading opportunity 5 days a week. The market is open 24 hours, 5 days a week, from all through the week, except the weekends. Also, Forex trading is highly transparent. It is one of the financial markets that is almost impossible to manipulate. It requires quite a great amount of assets for a group of individuals to unduly influence the market. So it's a highly transparent market, except nowadays that we have 1-2 people trying to bring manipulations, and that's the banks themselves trying to regulate interest rates and prices in a way that's not desirable to us traders. But we are coping up. That's what we said. We have to be dynamic with our strategies. We have to lay down a proper background knowledge on how to handle this. So how much do actually Forex traders make in this game? How much do Forex traders make in Forex? How much can you make? How much can me and you make trading Forex each and every day? So this is not a specific amount. I cannot tell you a trader makes 1 million pounds a day, 2 million pounds a day, 3 million pounds a day, because this depends on how much you are risking per trade. But actually, a dedicated Forex day trader with a decent strategy and a sound risk management can make between 5 to 15% a month. Leave alone those kind of people trying to tell you they can make 1,000% a month. But a decent strategy and sound risk management can actually make a realistic 5 to 15% a month. So if you're new to trading, you might wonder if it's possible to make a living from currency trading. Probably you can say yes, you can make a living out of currency trading. You can make something, you can pay rent, you can take your family for vacation, all those kind of things. As long as you have proper risk management and decent strategies that are going to make you consistent, obviously you are going to realize your dream. Also, our advice for you is to focus on the results and not on the money, because with a good skill set, you can trade in account size and leave even the most fancy places in the world you ever dreamt of. yes, you have to focus on the results, focus on developing your skills, focus on perfecting what you do, and leave alone all those kind of other things. Therefore, with a careful risk management and experienced and successful Forex trader with a 55% win rate, make your returns north of 20% per month. I hope you got that. So who are the major participants in this Forex market? The foreign exchange market is a place where money is denominated in one currency, bought and sold with money denominated in another currency. So it provides the physical and institutional structure through which the currency of one currency, one country is exchanged for another country. The rate of exchange between currencies is determined, and foreign exchange transactions are physically completed. Yes, so we have the banks. Without much ado, we have the banks. The major participants are the banks. We have the commercial banks, foreign exchange brokers, now the retail brokers who bring us into the game. We have the MNCs, individuals and small businesses too. So the primary purpose of this market being to permit a transfer of purchasing power denominated from one currency to another. The transfer of purchasing power, transfer of value from one currency to another. If you're exchanging euros for US dollars, it means that you're transferring purchasing power from the euro to the United States dollar. And in turn, this boosts business in these individual economies. So it will be convenient for individual buyers and sellers of foreign exchange to seek out one another. Yes, it would be so inconvenient, because you could not be going If you have a Chinese money, you want to change to Kenyan money, you cannot be going to China to look for Chinese who are going to exchange you the money. So as foreign exchange market has developed, it acts as an intermediary to these kind of transactions, and it makes it easier and efficient for them to happen. So those are the major participants in the Forex market. And we also have an expert. The nature of Forex trading is something that you're going to look at shortly before we finish. So the nature of Forex trading, how is Forex trading conducted? How is this business conducted? So we have a bulk of trading that is accounted by a small number of currencies. That's the United, the major currencies, the major economies only. That's like eight of them. We have the United States dollar, we have the Dutch mark, we have the yen, the pound sterling, the Swiss franc, the CAD, the Canadian dollar, and also the euro. And wholesale market comprises of large commercial banks, foreign exchange brokers, the wholesale market. Now, in this, we are talking this in terms of the guys who are selling and buying currencies in terms of wholesale. And also the interbank market, the banks and banks trading banks themselves, having the transactions themselves. We have commercial customers. We have primarily MNCs and central banks which intervene in the market from time to time to smooth exchange rate fluctuations or maintain target exchange rates. Yes. So over 90% of the total volume of transactions in this market is presented by interbank transactions, actually, and the remaining 10% done by banks and then unbanked customers. So you see the much percentage of what happens or the transactions that happen in this market is done by interbank, over 90%. So this means as a single retail trader, as a single individual trader, you don't have the ability to move price even by one pip, actually, because it takes almost 10,000 lots to move the price by one pip. And that's not something that you have the potential to do. So as many as 100, 200 banks across the country every day are involved in the market making business. This means these are about 100 to 200 investment banks across the world involved in this forex trading business. And so that's where it makes it very, very, very risky, because if you don't make your trading wisely, these guys will swallow your money in a day. So these banks operate in the foreign exchange market at two levels. You have at the retail level, where they deal with their customers, operations, exporters, and so forth, the large business, and also at the wholesale level, where they maintain the inert bank markets. Yeah, that's the inner market of the foreign exchange themselves, the banks trading with themselves, all the banks trading with small banks, also the banks trading with brokers, and this kind of liquidities. So the bulk of the activity actually in the foreign exchange is conducted in the interbank level. That's what you must take home, the bulk of activity. The retail world, we don't have so much that we have been trying to contribute or bring into the market, but much of this is done from the level of the interbank market. So whenever a bank buys a currency, it means in the foreign currency market, simultaneously selling another currency. And you know how banks can buy much sums of these currencies, because they have too many transactions and too many businesses going through their hands each and every day. So a bank that has committed itself to buying a certain particular currency, say to have a long position, that as you know, a bank that has committed itself to buy has a long currency position and a short currency position, for a bank that is committed to sell, amounts of currency exceeding the commitments to purchase it. So these aspects of longing and shorting of currencies. So the foreign exchange brokers are also involved in this business, because they actively and constantly monitor the price exchange rates from their screens, and also across all the board from the major international banks offering these through computerized system that the brokers have in their offices, such as Reuters. If you had a chance to visit one broker, you must have seen this. So by this, they are able to quickly find an opposite party for a client without revealing the identity of either party until a transaction has been agreed on. So as we make our orders from the backside, the broker sees our orders and tries to seek the most cheapest bid or offer being offered in the markets. And this is where he fills the order, and this is why he gets profit. So this is why the interbank traders use a broker that can primarily disseminate as quickly as possible the currency quote that is available as compared to many other dealers for the bank to fill the cheapest or the most expensive sell order in the market. So we'll study this on much and much of this on later in our coursework to see what makes a good Forex broker and a bad one. So also MNCs, individual and small businesses act in this market, and this is our sasa ni kina sisi, because we also use foreign exchange to facilitate our execution of commercial and also investment transactions. So you have functions of the foreign exchange market. What roles do the foreign exchange market play in each every day of our lives? So the foreign exchange market transfers purchasing power, as we said, across different countries, which results in enhancing the feasibility of international trade and overseas investments. Foreign exchange makes transfers of purchasing power because when you buy euros, you are selling United States dollars. It means you're just transferring the purchasing power from the euros, from the US dollars to the euros, because you're buying this purchasing power. You want to use these euros to do something. So it acts as a central focus also, whereby prices are set for different currencies. The central banks try to get into the game also to regulate the prices of the different currencies to at least try to stabilize the world economy because of things like inflation and such. So with the help of foreign exchange, investors can also hedge and minimize the risk of loss due to advanced exchange rate changes, overnight changes, day-to-day changes due to different kinds of economic activities happening in the individual countries, which makes speculation easy, and also market investors who are willing to hedge their positions also or protect their risks against future changes. So foreign exchange market simply allows traders to identify risk-free opportunities and arbitrage these away or throw these away. It allows us to identify risk-free opportunities. If you can find the dollar is very, very cheap and you're willing to buy the dollar and sell it expensive, these are free opportunities for you to make money and also have the trade that most Forex traders tend to take to their use. It also facilitates investment function of banks and corporate traders who are willing to expose their funds to currency risk. As we told you before, these are the kind of corporations like AQ, the kind of corporations like even United States Army trying to buy ammunition from a certain country using currency as their mode of payment. So through the banks and this Forex market, you can be able to do such a kind of investments, also try to protect or try to at least minimize the risk of loss or the minimal of change, adverse changing exchange rate. Sorry for that. We are going to look at, as we finish, we are going to look at, so the next, we come to the end of our brief actually. Next, we are going to look at, we are going to look at the history of foreign exchange and the sequence of events that came through. But before that I want to shortly take you through a simple subsection here that I prepared for you on how can you become a successful trader. Because actually, as you made a decision to learn Forex trading from the basics, from the grassroots, from the background, you have also to know and follow the steps on how you can become a good trader, a good professional trader. So as a good trader, you'll be looking to manage your personal life in a very, very simple way, because trading life is actually very, very different. It's actually a very simple lifestyle, but you have to be very, very disciplined, not only in trading, but general aspects of your life. You have to cut all the crap out of your life. You have to get focused. You have to arrange your personal life. You have to be orderly. You have to get your personal life actually like empty, because you need a fresh head. You need a fresh start every morning to read the market in a very fresh way, not having yesterday's or last week's bias to still inside your head. So this, you have to manage your personal life effectively. You have also to manage your work effectively so that you can balance on them and make actually make your trading life easy. you really have to keep it simple and keep your methodology simple and precise. You don't have to overcomplicate things here. Keep everything simple, keep your methodology simple and precise. This is a sure way that you're going to see success. So if your personal life and your business life is really hectic, it's gonna affect your trading decisions. This is one thing I can guarantee you. If your personal life, your business life is hectic, it affects your trading decisions. You won't succeed. And also your personal and trading life needs to mirror each other. The beginner who wants to be on top of this game, you have to have an incredible focus. You have to be organized and concentrate on making sure that your life is extremely simple and manageable through all times that you can make decisions with a clear head. Yes, as we told you, you have your personal life or your work life should mirror your personal life, and your personal life should mirror your trading life and vice versa. If your trading life is overcomplicated, your personal life is going to be affected inversely. And also if your personal life is overcomplicated and crappy and filled with all this kind of crap, that's how your trading life is going to be. So people who screw their personal lives always screw their trading lives and vice versa. If you screwed up your personal life, you're not organized, you're not orderly, you cannot you cannot account for your time, you cannot, all these kind of things, this means that for trading life is going to be very, very difficult for you because you are not going to manage, because trading is one of the fields that really needs very disciplined people. So to earn a professional status as a Forex trader takes years of commitment. Yes, that's true. And it's backed by clearly defined strategies that show consistent profitability. It's not something that happens overnight. It's not something that happens with one strategy. You have to go keep trying strategies, finding the right mentor behind your back, and also keeping the right kind of commitment and focus to your game, something that's going to show consistent profitability to you as time goes by. So pro traders can really earn high income in the lifestyle, but it doesn't come easy as always. It's not something that dreamt about one day and just come into realization of that dream. That's taken 10 years of hard work, years of trying and failing. Before they always there. So opportunities abound for these full-time players. They can choose to work for international banks. You can choose to work for an agent. You can choose to open your own trading company, or just put your pajamas and work out family home office just from the comfort of your home. So it's so much advantage that comes with being a pro trader, because the market actually gets so easy for you to navigate. And things get rolling. You don't have to struggle for things to get rolling for you. So with this comes a lot of hours and hours of commitment before your computers, before books, to humble yourself before the market, to learn each and every day, each and every day. And finally, you'll be there. So it is essential for you to put dedicated effort. It's not something that we are begging you for. It's very, very essential for you to put a dedicated effort into improving your trading game, trading skills. And we are proud to congratulate you for first taking the first step to joining this class Zoom today, because actually we are willing to take you through the right path that you need to take all through to see profitability. Because we want success for you as we also want success for ourselves. So finding a trading approach that suits you and has an edge, that's always something that you're going to chase. You always find a trading approach that suits you. Which kind of trader you are? Are you an intraday trader? Are you a scalper? Are you a swing trader? So finding a trading approach that suits for you is one of the things that is going also to make you earn this professional status as a Forex trader in this game. So as a beginning trader, don't forget to take the baby steps. Don't try to rush things. Don't try to make money when you don't know how to make that money. Don't try to rush things. Take your time and you'll be there. Finally, you'll be there. So this comes to the end of my presentation. Next, we're going to see the history of foreign exchange. And our next speaker, Ken, is going to take you through in our next video. So please, guys, cheers for coming through. Cheers for coming through. We are very, very proud of you. And see you in the next class. Bye-bye.